We are discussing the chapter 1, basics of internet. What is a website? Website is simply a folder. A folder which contains the web pages. In HTML and in various web technologies. So this is just a collection of web pages on the www World Wide Web, and that is accessed by its own internet address. So this folder is kept inside some web server and it has some IP address, and you can access it by the address of this website. So there are essentially collection of related web pages. So each website contains a home page from where you start, along with all the accompanying or additional pages. And it can be owned by, say, individual, company or organization. Since earlier times when they were only static pages, things have changed. Now we have websites which are very dynamic. How website is different from portal? Portal is a bigger form of website. Means, essentially, if you go to www.yahoo.com, you will see a web page, or you can say a home page, where you have news, you have weather, you have a search engine, all various things are there. You click some link and you are directed to that link. So web portal is a medium by which user access the resources, while the website is a destination on by itself. And they are two distinct entities. And as I just example that there is a Yahoo portal, and the yahoo.com or the email or the website can be accessed through this. Okay. So website is also a portal if it is going to broadcast information from different independent resources. So this, if it becomes, or the website starts having independent resource links, then you can say it is a web portal. But web portal essentially means, or it redirect you to some website or services that have varied resources. Like you can have on a portal email, forum, search engines, online shopping and whatnot. And we have various web portals. Some of the examples are AOL, iGoogle, Yahoo, and there are so many. And as we said, website is just a location where your web pages are stored. So it is a location or a domain name which is hosted on some server and which is accessed via the internet. So website is collection of web page, images, videos, and you put a URL, uniform resource locator, on your browser. On your browser, you just put this link or write this link. This URL finds that folder in that system web server, and then you can access it. So website provide content from independent resources to, say, some specific audience, and the content of website is quite focused and contains the material which need to be exist or that exist, and you can access it. And they are quite focused, means they are portraying or they are giving information of something which is of one you can say specified area. What are the components of website? A website has a web page, or they are a combination of web page. So a web page, first of all, the contents of a web page will be a web page of a website. It must, or it this is advisable, that it should contain basic element like the page title, the URL, the file name, the header, footer, navigation, web page content. These are all the parts of the composition of a web page. Now the latest is HTML5 and CSS3. So now we have audio, video, all this can be kept inside a website. Then we have graphics. And since this totally depends on the internet speed you have. So if you want to put graphic, you have to see, because website you can have graphic. There are so many websites which provide graphics. Then the heading of the site, this is very crucial, because the search engine, they are going to take this web heading of the website, then only they are going to index it so that people can access it. Color contrast, even for those who have poor vision or color deficiencies, your color should be such that the combination should be such that they should be perceptible and soothing, and people should visit it again and again. Like you can't have a black background and a white color on top. That will be very difficult for various people to again visit your website. So what are the elements of website? If you are dealing with website, or you intend to make a website or maintain a website, your website should have a very good visual design. A site must be appealing, must be professional, and it should reflect, if you are dealing, you are making it for some company, it should reflect your company, your products and your services. Today, the websites are made responsive. That is, even if you use it on a tablet or a phone or on a desktop, you'll be able to see, or the web pages are going to change or acquaint themselves according to the screen. Then of course the color scheme and formatting, as I just said, there are certain colors that are good for website, and the text formatting should be good. The font should be of proper size, like 10 to 12 is ideal. Then the graphics should be meaningful. Whatever you are giving in website shows your character, your company's character. So that has to be very, very clean so that customer could visit it. It should be simple for anyone who is coming, because anyone can come. You have opened it for the world. Now, if you have complex design, animation or various other effect, that is going to, if they are good, they are going to impress your viewers. If they are not good, they are going to annoy your users. And the content should be relevant. You know, you can't put the irrelevant things on your website that will make a customer to leave your website and don't come back again. Navigation means, if a user comes on a website, he should get the links such that he may be able to visit various other pages and he may be able to come back. So all these, you have to make your page, break them in such a way, organize in such a way so that you don't frustrate the visitor. The hyperlink should be active. They must point to the pages you want a user to be sent. Then the scrolling should be less, means a long page nobody is going to read. Consistent layout. Every page should have some consistent layout. Then cross platform or browser capability. The website you are designing must cater to various browsers which are available, various cross platform like macOS, like Windows, etc. How to construct a website? Before constructing a website, you have to see that when you make a website, you don't only put in some folder in your computer. You have to give it to or open it to the world. For that, you have to buy. Say you go to GoDaddy or HostGator. There are so many. You have to find a place in the web server of the web hosting service. For that, you need to buy a place and buy it for some years, like 1 year, 2 year, 3 year, and you have to buy a name also, the domain name of your website, by which user are going to put the URL of your website, and that will come. So first step is hosting. So first step is on constructing a website is to decide about the web hosting provider. There are so many, and there are several types of web hosting option available. Free web hosting is also there, and you can have payment based web hosting is also there. Then domain name, the URL, that is the domain which user is going to know, or your website or your web pages are known, will be known by this name. So you have to buy that. Then plan your website. After you have decided, or you have got the domain name and for how many years that domain will be active, now you have URL also. Now make your website. Make a website in the latest technology. Use the server side technology and client side technology, like the HTML, the JavaScript, the jQuery, the PHP, the ASP, the there are so many. You can take advantage of the latest technologies, and then you can make a good website. Select the type of website, because you can either provide information, you can provide product or reference site. So just use a good language, good formation. Then, because website can have one page, even one page can also be called as a website. But because nowadays a website can have multiple pages, so these are multiple pages you have to make. And publish your website now. You have made a website, now you have a URL. Now there are so many FTP clients that your I hope the hosting service is going to provide you this FTP client. Now you have made the pages, now you can do the FTP. You can send it to the server, web server, where you have taken the place. And then means if you update also, you change also, you can, using the FTP client, you can send it. Now the thing is, website you need to promote. The only making a website is not going to work. You have to tell people, you have to do certain promotions so that people understand, know where your website. There are so many ways you can make a Facebook page, you can send to your friends, try them to visit your website. Once it is popular, then your business activity can go on. Then website cannot be left idle. You have to see the latest trends in the market. What is going on? You have to change the things accordingly, make your page dynamic, and visit and change them on the regular basis. So there are various software. Not only one software is used for making a website. For example, this is a coffee cup free HTML editor. You have Dreamweaver. If you want a very lightweight, application to make or to write the HTML content, then you can go for a Notepad++. This cater variety of web technologies. We have PageBreeze, Firebug, Bluefish Editor, Bracket, so many. Composer, OpenBexy, and GIMP for, you have to put some images also. Blue Griffon. So I'm just giving you an example. If you search your search engine, you'll find the latest one which are being used. Now, what is a web page? You might have worked on Word, Microsoft Word. You make a page. You write something in the form of a paragraph. You give spaces. You insert images. You insert table. So this page is simply a web page. Means when you publish it in the form of HTML on the internet, or now this page becomes available when you make it as HTML, it becomes available to the users on the internet, this becomes a HTML page. So web page is also known as electronic page. This is a part of World Wide Web, and it's just like a page of your book. So basic unit of every website or document on the web is web page, which contains the information. The web page may have article, single paragraph, photographs, combination of text and graphics. So a web page may contain some static area or may contain some dynamic areas. The static page will not change, means static part will not change. Dynamic page will change. Dynamic part will change. Say you are putting your vision. Now your vision and your ideas, they are static. The company has a static vision. Well, but say you are making a website for cricinfo.com. Now some cricket is going on. You want to change the score every second, every microsecond. So that is how this dynamicity comes into picture. So static and dynamic areas are like this. So what makes a web page work? What happens when you see a website and web page work? See, first is the server receives the request from a page sent by a browser. So here is the browser. You write a URL. Now this client sends a request to the server. Now this is a web server. There is a page. There is a website here. Now this link or this address will request. Now the browser connect to the server through some IP address. This web server has some IP address. This IP address is obtained by, on the background we have domain name server. So this is going to translate the content you write to the IP address. So in return now, the server will send the page, required page, to the browser. So what is the difference between a web page and a website? Web page is a single page. A single page can also be a website. But a website is made up of number of different pages. And this website, they are hosted properly and they have hyperlinks so that you may navigate between different web pages. What is a web browser? Browser is an application. It is a software. Now, this browser has an address bar. Here you put the address, say enter, and this will connect to the web server. And then you get the website here. So, browser is a software that lets you view the web pages, graphics and online content. And this browser software is specifically designed to convert this HTML and XML into your readable format, means you can read this. HTML is a language, okay? XML is also a kind of language. But if you are able to see it in a proper way, that is web browser. So there are various web browsers, Google Chrome, Firefox, Internet Explorer, Safari, Opera, UC browser, there are so many. So browser, typically this is just an example. This contains various buttons like the back button. What you have opened just now, you can back it. What you have accessed after this, you can forward it. This is a back buttons. For a button, if something is loading, you can stop it. If something is not loading, you can refresh it. Then you have home, that is the home page will be seen. You can search on this website. These are the favorite website you are visiting. This is a history of all the website or all the pages you have been to. So these are all options which you generally find in your web browser. But right now, the browsers like Chrome and Firefox, they provide you with so many options apart from this. So this is the one more discussion on basics of internet. We'll be taking one more. Till then, thank you so much. Take care of yourself.